Okay, new recording. End of class one. some of you will be asking, like, why is she not talking about LGBT? Why is she not talking about race? Why is she not talking about economic inequality? These are fundamental problems. Why is she focusing on male, female, right? And so this is one of the key issues in Irigaray. According to her, once we reestablish the balance between male and female, all the other problems will fall into place, right? They will be resolved. Because for her, it is this fundamental imbalance which is causing the economic inequality, the racism, the issues against the LGBT community coming from the inequality between male and female. The moment you reestablish the connection and the balance, all the other problems, right? Whether it's LGBT rights or, you know, the crimes that are committed against them, or the inequalities or racism, this all falls. So that's why she's focusing so much, right, on the male-female, right? It's not that she's neglecting the others. Of course, any relationship is important, but she's saying it's not just about the relationship. It's about cosmic harmony, right? So she's not just saying, oh, you know, let's talk about these relationships and they're the only ones that, you know, are really normal. No, she admits there are other types of relationships, but for her, this particular relationship is the basis of cosmic harmony, and that's why she hones in on that. Does that answer the questions of that I'm reading in the minds of some of you? Or are you still a little bit iffy with her? I've gotten a lot of pushback over the years when I'm teaching Irigaray, so I'm expecting it. No pushback? You guys are tired and depressed, aren't you? You don't want to work anymore. Oh, okay. You need a vacation. All right, we'll give you a vacation. Can we stop the recording before everybody knows about